As the Petersburg crowd filled the streets for stage 20, we spoke to a rather tired-looking Nick Duvall.
Nick, they say one of the toughest rallies in 5 years. How do you feel? You've actually pulled yourself up quite well.
Yes, no, that is certainly true. We've had a very long night, 20 hours non-stop so far, and we've only done two-thirds of the event. And it's been very tight and very hard work throughout the night.
Now, apparently there are only 20 cars left in the event. How's your car standing up to the stages?
The car is going very well at the moment. We lost a lot of time, but it was mainly due to punctures and other mechanical problems. But the car is now in tip-top shape, and with the second overall position at the moment, I think if everything goes well, we can pull it off and hopefully finish first.
The situation is poised for a grand finale. By their own admission, the Nissan will have to be nursed to the finish. Duvall, on the other hand, has a strong car and a target time to work on. Of the 8 night stages, Habeck beat Duvall on only 2. 10 stages remain, a total of 131 kilometres. Adding to the drama up front is the Pond League Sapphire, which is currently lying 4th and only 30 seconds behind Hall and Buerta. But their problem is not what lies ahead, rather the charging Glenn Gibbons just 2 minutes behind. The tar stages suit Tony Pond's driving style, and the crowd appreciates the spectacle. Glyn Hall and Martin Buerta find themselves defending their third place from Pond and Leek. They have a great deal more to lose by getting caught up in a dogfight for third place. As far as the championship is concerned, at stage 20 here in Petersburg, Hall and Buerta lead Kuhn and Seeling by 18 points, while Habeck and Judd lie 1 point behind Kuhn. All three teams currently lead their classes. Should this golf retire and Enzo Kuhn drop just one place, Habeck and Judd would take the championship. Obviously, Hall and Buerta are driving to finish the event and thereby take the championship in this battered Class B car. Tony Ball and Tony Babb lead a three-car Class D battle down in eighth place. We asked Tony Ball, as a privateer, how the rally was going.
There have been a few rough stages, but the particularly long one was 42 Ks. And it was tight and twisty. I think I got into fourth gear twice, and I've actually got blisters on my hand, and I think this is what rallying's all about, and I know Van feels that way too. These long open roads are not rallies.
But it was on the long open stage 22 that we found Nick Duvall's conquest obviously in distress. The Toyota has maimed itself by hitting a gully at over 200 kilometres an hour. The front tyre has shredded while the back hub needed replacing. Duvall's hopes for a victory were fading fast. As Yanni Habeck and Douglas Judd finish special stage 23, news comes through that Nick Duvall has retired from the rally. With the pressure off from the conquest, the Nissan crew can now back off and nurse their car to the finish. Tony Pond's experience on tar roads like this one on stage 23 shows on the scoreboard as he wins the stage by 14 seconds. This is bad news for Glenn Gibbons, who, in Duvall's absence, needs a place in the top order for Toyota. Clearly, the fight of the day is to be Toyota against Ford. While Habeck can relax, Pond and Leek's day is just starting. The remaining stages favour Gibbons in the more powerful four-wheel drive Toyota. Glenn Gibbons and Peter Cuffley rise to the occasion and immediately go out and win the very next stage. This pair have had an eventful rally, as can be seen by the side of their car. The regroup at Zanin saw them back in 13th place. During the night, they fought back to 5th place and have been biting at the Ford's heels ever since. So much for the action up front. Looking down the field, we find husband and wife team, John and Sherry Saunders, in 13th place. Second in Class D are Chart van der Valt and navigator Cindy Harding, Only 1 minute separate them from the Simonized golf of Tony Ball and Tony Babb. August Probler and Yarpie Barnard are one of the many privateers who've made it to the home straight in this, the toughest rally to date. Visiting Scottish driver Jimmy Girvan finds the going tough, with conditions far from the norm in Scotland. Navigating for him is local lad Alan Castley. From here, on stage 24, the route heads south via Nailstrom to Pretoria. Six stages remain, and human fatigue starts to take a toll, with the crews having had no sleep in 24 hours. Around the Houses stage in Nailstrom brings the locals out in their throngs, and Yanni Havoc rises to the occasion. The rear-wheel drive Ford Sapphire, driven by Tony Pond, is equally thrilling for the crowd. Pond currently holds the record time around the Isle of Man on four wheels, and it's with some surprise that Glyn Hall and Glenn Gibbons post an equally fast time on the stage, 1 minute and 53 seconds. The fight for Class D honours continues as Ball and Babb shake off a determined chase from Van der Vault and Harding. Glyn Hall and Martin Boerter have bravely fought off a charging Tony Pond and Glenn Gibbons. Their battered Volkswagen 16-valve GTI doing an incredible job under these conditions and furious pace. Behind them, Glenn Gibbons has won four of the previous five stages. Gibbons now has his sights firmly set on this valuable second position. The penultimate stage is here at the new Acacia Flat Track Raceway. We pick up on the now fourth-placed Ford as Pond pilots the Sapphire through this unique stage. Must be given to Pond and Leek, who together with the Ford Motorsport team have done an incredible job in their return to competitive national rallying. The drive of the day must go to this team, Gibbons and Cuffley, who after Duval's retirement won five out of the last seven stages in an effort to bring Toyota up into the results. At Church Square in Pretoria, Yanni Havoc and Douglas Judd proudly take their place on the winner's podium. Their win was a tactical drive, which looked easy by comparison to the battles going on behind them. This win on the West Bank gives Havoc and Judd a total of three first places for the season. Add to that, Hannes Krobler's two victories, and that gives Nissan a total of five wins out of eight events.
From the start, we predicted that it would be a difficult event, so we decided to pace ourselves for the first half anyway, and then see on the second half what would happen. But the people fell out in the first half, so we had quite a free run in the second half of the event, which we managed to win then eventually.
And the car, did it give you any problems?
Yes, we had quite a few small problems, like side shafts, suspension bending, but it all stayed together and got to the end.
And what about next year? You, obviously, this gives you a lot of confidence for the season next year.
We'll definitely give it a full go.
Well done.
Thank you.
The heroes of the rally must be Glyn Hall and Martin Boerter, who, against all odds, not only finished the event, but took second place honours. This result gave them a convincing 18-point victory in the championship, achieved in a Class B car. Gibbons and Cuffley finished the event third, but only 28 seconds behind Hall and Boerter. Of the 61 starters in the event, only 18 eventually made it to the finish. Yanni Habak and Douglas Judd with a clear win in their Nissan Sentra. Glyn Hall and Martin Buerta hold on to second place in the Volkswagen Golf GTI. A well-deserved third place to Glenn Gibbons and Peter Cuffley, who fought off Tony Pond and Richard Leek into fourth place. Enzo Kuhn and Johan Seeling finished fifth, ahead of teammates Kasi Kutsia and Ivar Peltz, who was sixth. Ball and Babb were seventh, Van der Valt and Harding finished eighth. Class A honours went to Habak and Judd. This class had a total of six finishers. Hall and Buerta were the only survivors in Class B. Enzo Kuhn won Class C ahead of six other competitors, while Tony Ball and Tony Babb led home four Class D cars. The 1990 South African National Championship was hard fought for this year. Derman and Reeler led at one stage, as did Chadwick and Constable. Kuhn and Seeling then took the lead for two events. Only in the penultimate rally did Hall and Buerta emerge as the leaders, with Cobbler and Swanepoel 1 point behind. So ended an exciting and entertaining season of South African rallying.